Several activities in historic places in Cavite and Bulacan were conducted as part of the commemoration of the country's 125th Independence Day celebration. High-ranking national and local officials were on hand to lead these slated events meant to remind the public of our nation's storied past. Patrick De Jesus has more.
125 years ago, from this grand hall window of General Emilio Aguinaldo's home in Cavite, Cavite, the Philippine flag was formally unfurled and the country's independence was proclaimed. Now, the mansion of Aguinaldo serves as national shrine and museum. While the national anthem was being played, Executive Secretary Lucas Versamin raised the Philippine flag. This, as he led the program earlier at the Aguinaldo Shrine and Museum, in line with the celebration of the 125th Philippine Independence. Local officials of Cavite also attended the event, including Congressman Jolo Revilla and Cavite Mayor Angelo Emilio Aguinaldo. Despite the heavy rains in the morning, the parade pushed through as part of the program. In his speech, E.S. Versamin stressed the importance of remembering the details in the declaration of our country's independence and that the sacrifices of our heroes for this should always serve as an inspiration.
They gave much of themselves, including their own lives, out of love for our country and people in the struggle to win freedom and independence from foreign domination. As for me personally, my participation today is no less a pilgrimage to this hallowed shrine of Philippine independence.
At the Barasuin Church in Malolos, Bulacan, Supreme Court Chief Justice Alexander Gismundo led the ceremony. He mentioned the judiciary reforms being implemented that aim to bring modern and humanly justice for everyone.
Kaya tungkulin nating bantayan hindi lang ating kalayaan at kapakanan, kundi pati ng kapwa natin, ng bawat isa sa atin, at hindi lang para sa kapwa nating nabubuhay ngayon, kundi para sa mga susunod na henerasyon.
Other activities were also conducted in Bulacan, such as the 2023 Kalayaan Job Fair at the Capitol Gym, with more than 9,000 job vacancies from 63 local employers and 13 overseas agencies.
Kasabay po lagi 'yon, yung job fair na 'yon. Ano po? At 'yon, para mabigyan natin ng trabaho, part 'yon ng ating programa nitong event na ito, yung paggunita sa kalayaan, pagbibigay naman ng hanap buhay sa mga Bulakenyo.
Simple, short, but meaningful. This is how the Philippine independence was commemorated in Angeles, Pampanga. Representatives from the National Historical Commission of the Philippines and local government attended the program. The Pamintuan Mansion was witness to historical events in the Philippines. It was constructed in the 1880s and was owned by Don Mariano Pamintuan and Valentina Torres as gift to their son Florentino, who then served as Angeles mayor. The house also served as headquarters of first Philippine President General Emilio Aguinaldo when he transferred the seat of power from Cavite to Pampanga. The first Philippine independence anniversary was celebrated here. Currently, the mansion is now called Museum of Philippine Social History. Cebu City also participated in the celebration of Independence Day. A mass was held at Fuente Osmeña attended by national and local government agencies. This was followed by a flag-raising ceremony in Plaza Independencia led by Cebu City Mayor Michael Rama. There was also a float parade by different organizations depicting events in the country. In Davao City, a simple ceremony was held by local officials. This was kicked off with a flag-raising ceremony and wreath-laying at the monument of Dr. Jose Rizal. Davaoenos were reminded to commemorate the life of our heroes and serve as a guide in their everyday life. Patrick De Jesus for The Nation.